Hi everybody, welcome to my crafting table. This is Miss Judy and I have another card to share with you today from using the May May stamp set called Country Pumpkin and using some cuts from the art booking cartridge. And the card I want to share with you is actually called a bookmark card. And I'm going to show you how to cut that. You need an 8.5 by 11 size piece of cardstock. Then you will cut it to 5 1/8 inch. So I'm going to do that. I'll be right back. 5 1/8. My table is a mess. I don't want anyone to be looking at it, but that's okay. After you have cut it to 5 1/8, then you will do 2 score lines. I'm going to use my and you will do a score line at 4 1/4, 8.5, which means that I'm just going to turn this over on the other side and score at 2 1/2. So, okay, once you have done those score lines, then you will take your base and you will do the fold into the middle and the fold over. What this does is it creates, and I've seen several different ones like this, but this is the way I've done most of mine. Some people will cut off this little flap right here, which is cool. Some people will actually make another fold and create something like this for a card, for the bookmark card. But after you've done your folds, then you want to take your perforator. And what I use for my perforator is a handy dandy seam. It's called a carbon tracer. I used to use this when I sewed a lot. And I use it in my card making as a perforator. I have another kind of little tool, but really had a hard time doing it. So on the short flap, you want to take some kind of a perforating tool, whatever you like to use, and you're just going to go down that seam and perforate it. And the reason you want to do that is that way whomever gets your bookmark card can tear off this side for a bookmark. I would typically do it a little bit heavier. I just wanted to show you what I was doing. So here's the card I did using May May stamps and some cuts from the art booking cartridge. I did some stash paper that had spider webs all over it. And she has the cutest little stamp in here that says Surf the Web with a spider on it. So I thought, ooh, I'm going to put that on this spider web paper. I embellished with a fence that I altered in the Cricut craft room. It's actually this fence right here, and I made it shorter, and I made it at 4 1/4 inches. And then I cut out this spider. I think it was from Create a Critter 2, but then I looked up here, and there's a spider up here in the art booking. So those are found on page 70 and 71 in the art booking cartridge. You almost don't need any other cartridges except the ones that Close to My Heart makes. So I put that on the front. I popped up Surf the Web. I stamped that in some Colonial White stamping, Close to My Heart ink that is, takes a little bit longer. It's called White Daisy. It's a pigment base and it takes a little longer to dry, so you just have to kind of be careful when you're drying it. But I stamped that, Surf the Web, and then on the inside, I decorated the inside part with some of the spider web paper and a piece of black. I added one more little spider at the top and I said, read about it. That's what we do when we surf the web, correct? And then this is the bookmark end. And what I did was just use a piece of black, piece of the spider web. I did add a spider on here. On the back, just used the black layer and the spider web layer. I punched a hole and then I tied some little silvery ribbon I had in my stash, and you fold it in like this, and there's your bookmark card. So you can write your sentiment to someone and along in here or over here, either one if you don't have a white pen. And then whomever gets your card can open it up, read about it, and have a bookmark to use, a Halloween bookmark. So that's my card for today, using May Made It Country Pumpkin stamp set, brand new, so cute, and her stamps just stamp beautifully. And then using the Art Booking Cricut cartridge, and this fits into an A2 size card. You do not have to use extra stamps. I've mailed lots of these bookmarking cards to different people. So that's my video. I have one more I'm doing with a kind of a little summary and another project that I'm working on with the Halloween May Made It stamp sets. And I will be sharing that with you later on. I do appreciate y'all watching my videos. It's what I call my comic relief. I do enjoy talking to all of you all. I've met lots of you. You called and you emailed and I appreciate it. I love hearing from you. I love talking to myself. So I guess that's why I have so much fun doing this. So anyway, have a wonderful day. Love you. Bye.